Greetings for the day. My name is Mohammad Ahmed Ali. Welcome to another session of Computer Networks. In today's session, we're going to learn about what do you mean by a concatenated virtual network, connectionless internet working and tunneling, and some part of fragmentation, what actually fragmentation is all about. So coming towards this internet working and all the things, if at all if you remember in the previous session, we studied about a general view or a general outcome or a general view about what networking is all about, what internet working is, and what are the different types of network that is being used within the computer networks, and what are the benefits and what are the advantages of different types of networks. Now, if at all if you have a network, you will be having a source, a destination, some of the connecting devices and some of the medium or by which the messages or the information or the packets can be sent from one source to another destination, or from source to destination, or from first to last node of the network. Now, what actually do you mean by internet working? What do you actually mean by internet working? Within a network, there can be subnetworks. There can be subnetworks. But in sense, if at all, if I take a small example of this college, in one of the college, you will be having different departments, and every other department will have its own classes, like first year, second year, third year, final year. Whereas the same way, every other college will have different departments like computer science, engineering, IT, mechanical, civil, electrical, and instrumentation, etc. type of departments. In a network, there are some subnetworks which need to communicate with one another. For instance, for computer science engineering, there might be some of the subjects which are from electronics department, and there can be some subjects which are from electronics department, electrical department, and as well as from electronics department. So in this way, one department need to connect with another department. One department need to get connected with another department. In the same way, this type of thing is called as internet working. This type of networking is called as internet working. In the same way, what internet working says, internet working is a process or technique of connecting different networks by using intermediary devices such as router or gateway devices. Technically, if you are speaking, when you are talking about computer networks, there should be some of the medium and devices by which that communication that can be connected, that all of the devices can be interconnected. That is what we call as internet working. When you compare the same thing with reference to your college, there are HODs which will be communicating with one another to deal with that particular subject in that particular semester. This is what you called as internet working. This is actually what you called as internet working. Within a network, there are subnetworks. These subnetworks are communicating with one another to make a subnetwork in which one device can communicate with another device through a medium, that is gateway or routers or anything. Now, coming to the second point, what it says, internet working ensures data communication among networks owned and operated by different entities using a common data communication and the internet routing protocols. So what are the things, like for instance, there is a subject called as electronic device and circuits or electrical engineering in computer science, or basic electrical engineering or basic electrical electronics in one of the subject in computer science department. So that particular subject should be dealt with that particular department faculty only. For instance, in that particular department, there is a faculty of basic electrical electronics, and there is another faculty of different subject. So in that faculty also, a particular faculty who can teach this particular subject should be assigned to you. That is what we call as, in computer terminology, you call it as internet routing protocols. That is what we call as internet routing protocol. In the sense, you have a communication channel, you have a communication medium, but you don't have the protocols to communicate with one another. Though there is a department called electrical in the college, but there is no faculty who can teach that particular subject. This can be possible. So we need to hire that particular faculty. In the same way, we need to have that routing protocol within our network to make a common communication, to make a common communication with one network to another network. We are not talking about whole network, we are talking about the two sub networks within a big network. Okay, now what is the third point, which says internet networking is only possible when all the connected networks use the same protocol stack or communication methodologies. This is the thing that I am telling you from the first session, that when you are communicating within the network, every of the protocols should be able to communicate with one another, so that there should be a proper communication and every of the node can reach from every of the part of the network to the next destination. So this is the reason why this has been repeatedly said, that every of the connected network should use the same protocol. For an instance, like a small example I'll give you, like this class has been conducted. This class is to be conducted at that particular time. For instance, this class is to be conducted at 3 p.m. on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. If at all the students are coming on Wednesday, Thursday, Friday at the same time, 3 p.m., will they be able to attend the class? No, they will not be able to attend the class. And also on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, if at all they are coming at 2 o'clock, can they attend the class? No, they cannot attend the class because they are not maintaining the protocol. In essence, what is the protocol? Protocol means it is a set of instructions to execute a particular product or a particular thing. That is what you call as a protocol. If at all the class is at 3 o'clock, if at all you are coming at 3 o'clock, you will be able to access the class and you can able to see what is going on in the class. So this is the sense, if at all everyone is coming at one particular time, that means everyone is following the protocol, everyone is following the time protocol. So this is what you call as a protocol. Things when it comes to computer networks, every of the protocols, the different types of protocols that we are going to study in the coming sessions, and also I have shown you some of the previous protocols like TCP/IP, UDP and all those things. I have just gave you an overview. We will study about all these things in the coming sessions. But as of now, think that there are some rules and there are some instructions which need to be executed so that our task of sending the packets from one source to second destination or third destination or end destination should be achieved without delay, without losing of the packets and with quality of services. So this should be maintained within the network. This is what we call as internetworking. Now coming towards the next part, what it says, computer networks that provide connection oriented services are called virtual circuits. Now coming towards the properties of the networks, there are basically two types of networks based on their orientation of connections. The first one is connection oriented protocol, the second one is connectionless protocol. You should remember these things. Like connection oriented in the sense that particular network will be physically connected with one another, or that type of network which is being connected within a particular region, that type of networks are called as connection oriented service, or it is also called as virtual circuits. Now whenever a computer is being connected with wide type of network, then it is called as a virtual circuit or connection oriented network. If at all the same connection is being provided through A or through with radio waves, that net type of network is called as connectionless network, or also called as datagram networks. We are going to see what actually it is. Now coming towards what it says, computer networks that provides connection oriented service are called virtual circuits, while those providing connectionless services are called as datagram networks. Basically there are two types of networks based on the orientation of connections. The first one is connection oriented, which is also called as virtual circuits. The second type is connectionless, which is also called as datagram network. Now for further we move, what it says, for prior knowledge, the internet which we use is actually based on datagram network or connectionless. At the network level, as all packets from a source to destination do not follow the same path. Now, when the things are what you call as connection oriented, it means you are bound to some particular things, you are bound to some particular way or path by which the traffic will be moving, by which the packets will be moving, by which the information will be passed from one source to another destination. For instance, you have been told to move from one place to second place following the path A to B, B to C, C to D, D to E. These are the paths you are going to follow. So it means this is what we call as connection oriented, like we are creating the connection between the routes, like this is the only route that you need to follow. In the same way, when it comes to connection oriented services, that particular connection will be preoccupied with some pre-routes that it will follow, so that the source and destination can receive the packets. Whereas in connectionless, the route is not defined. It will take dynamic route based on the traffic and based on the network. In this also you will be receiving the packet, but comparatively virtual circuit will provide you better quality of services. In the sense, all of the packet that you have sent will be received at the destination, whereas in connectionless type of network, you will be able to receive the packets, but the packets may not be in sequence. Some of the packets might be missing, but there is a surety that connectionless type of network will maintain the traffic of the network. If at all, if I give you a small instance, example. Considering an example of a train and an example of a two-wheeler or a vehicle, they are moving parallelly, and at some instance, two of the trains has come one opposite to another. It means after the first train moves, then only second train can move. Whereas with reference to a two-wheeler, the two-wheeler can take an alternative path to reach the destination, whereas the train cannot take an alternative path to reach the destination. This is the major difference between connection oriented and connectionless. Connection oriented is an example of train, connectionless is an example of a two wheeler. So this is a major difference. Both of the packets will receive, both of the people will go to the destination, but here every of the packet that is being, like every of the box or every of the what you call as train box or what you call as the coach of every of the train will reach the destination. Whereas when it comes to two-wheeler, some of the things might get fall from the two-wheeler. There is a chance, but not sure, but there is a chance that some of the things might get fall. But both of the connection will reach the destination. Both of the network will reach the destination. But here, the quality of services is different. Here the quality of services is every of the packet will be received. Here the quality of service is, it is based on the traffic and it is based on the network capacity as it takes a dynamic route. Both has got its own importance at different level. Okay, this is what we call as computer network with reference to connection oriented service and with reference to connectionless service. Now moving forward, what actually is concatenated virtual circuit? What it says, the first point it says is it is a connection oriented, meaning that every means that there is a reservation of resources like buffer, CPU, bandwidth and etc. In the sense, it will preoccupy every other thing that is being needed to transfer the packet of information from source to the destination. Every of the packet that need to be transferred from source to destination, it will take all of the resources required to satisfy that packet to receive from the sender or from receive from the receiver to the sender. Pardon my mumbling. The packet that need to be received from the receiver to the sender, every of the resources will be preoccupied, like buffer, CPU and bandwidth. for the time in which a newly set up virtual circuit is going on to be used by a data transfer session. Now, at the first instance, when the first packet is being sent from receiver to the sender, it will take a path, it will take the resources. But from the second packet, it does not need more resources. The resources that was been taken from the first packet, it will follow the same path. It will follow the same path. That is the second point. What it says: the first sent packet reserves resources at each server along the path. Subsequent packets will follow the same path as the first sent packet from the connection time. It's something like a train. We have an engine which is been followed by the following coaches. It means only the first coach will take all of the resources. This is the what we call as a concatenated virtual circuit. Now, what the third point it says, since all the packets are going to follow the same path, a global header is required. A global header is required, which means only the first packet of the connection requires a global header. The remaining packet generally don't require the global header. Global header in the sense, the address that need to be followed. The address that need to be followed from source to the destination. From source to the destination. That is what we call as a global header. Now what is the fourth one which says, since all packets follow a specific path, packets are received in order at the destination. In the sense, like when the train is moving, first the engine will come, then first coach, second coach, third coach, fourth coach, fifth coach. In this way, it will arrive at the destination. Whereas in connectionless, when we are moving, the person who is behind me can reach first, or the person who is in front of me can reach first. It can, anything can happen. Anything can happen. Now, what it says is like, you know, the packet that is been received from the receiver will be in order. It will be in order. Now, what is the fifth point? The fifth point says, virtual circuit switching ensures that all packets successfully reach the destination. It means virtual circuit switching will always ensure, with reference to the quality of services, that all of the packet reaches the destination. No packet will be discarded due to unavailability of resources. Unavailability of the resources in the sense, when we are taking actual resources that is required to execute that particular operation, there is no chance that there will be unavailability of resources. Now, coming, like, this is like, you know, you want 10 benches for 10 students. Like, 10 benches is allotted to 10 students means there is no unavailability of resources. Every of the student has got one bench to write, to sit and write the examination. So this is what the point says. Now, sixth point says, from the above point, it can be concluded that virtual circuits are a highly reliable method of data transfer. It is a highly reliable source of data transfer. Like, for everything you have a positive point and also you have a negative point. That is only the reason we are using it. The negative points can be less and the positive points can be good. So that is only the reason that part of things is being used majorly across the globe. This is the thing that happens. So with reference to the virtual circuit also, this is a best source to transfer the data from source to destination without losing a packet. Now, what is the disadvantage? The disadvantage is the issue with virtual circuit is that each time a new connection is to set up, resources and extra information have to be reserved at every router along the path. In the sense, like, for every other people you are giving one bench. In the sense, there might be some of the students who are coming late, they cannot get the bench. So this is a disadvantage with reference to virtual circuit network. In the sense, when you are occupying every of the resources on the network, it means the later on coming packets may not get the complete resources to execute that particular operation. There is a chance that this particular operation cannot be executed based on the current resources of that router. So for that reason, this particular type of virtual circuit or this type of connection oriented service is not possible. If at all if you have larger resources, then this can be taken as a best example for sending the information from source to the destination. Whereas if at all you want just to transfer the data, then you will be going for what we call as connection less type of networks. Now what it says is like, you know, resources and extra information have to be reserved at every router along the path, which becomes problematic if many clients are trying to reserve a router's resources simultaneously. This is a disadvantage with reference to connection oriented or virtual circuits. Now coming forward, what it says is the connectionless internet working or datagram network. It means this does not follow a particular path. This is independent of taking a path. This is all dependent on the traffic, route and dynamic resources. For instance, like if you want to reach from A to B and the intermediate connections are C, D, E, if at all C is not working, it will take the path to D. If at all C and D is not working, it will take the path for E. It means this is dynamic. This is dynamic. In the sense, the resources and information is with reference to the traffic of the network and with reference to the available resources of the network. But this will lead in to delay of the packets or loss of the packet. In the sense, there might be some of the packet which can be lost as the path is moving on dynamic way. Now what this connectionless type of internet networking or datagram network says, it is a connectionless service. There is no need for reservation of resources as there is no dedicated path for a connection of session or connection session. Second point what it says, all packets are free to use any available path. As a result, intermediate routers calculate routes on the go due to dynamically changing routing tables or routers. In the sense, you are moving from one place to another place, and at some place there is a traffic jam, or there is some accident being taken, there is some construction going on, or there is some of the thing that is been going on that path, and that is it will take a longer path to complete. So what you will do, you will take an alternate path from that particular place. So it means for every of the dynamic path that is being taken, the routing table should be updated so that whenever the next packet is coming, if at all it is coming from the same path, it should be rerouted. So that there should not be any delay in the network. There should not be any delay and congestion of the network. Now in the last session we have studied about the congestion control algorithm and all those things, where we have studied like how congestions can be avoided. The basic thing with reference to computer network is to reduce the congestion, to improve the quality of services, to improve the services of our routers, and to use the maximum resources that has been available within the network. Now what the second point says, all packets are free to use any available path. As a result, intermediate routers calculate routes on the go due to dynamically changing routing tables on the routers. This was the second point what I have told you just now. For the third point, which is says, since every packet is free to choose any path, all packet must be associated with a header with proper information about the source and the upper layer data. In this sense, as the packets are moving dynamically, every of the header should be indicated with where it should go and to which packet it belongs. It means every of the packet that is being sent from the sender or to the receiver, the packet information should be with the header and with reference to the destination where it should go. In a sense, like, you know, when you are writing a letter, you will be writing to address and from address. That can be taken, or that letter can move from any place, but it will reach the destination. but it will reach the destination. Whereas when you send a message on WhatsApp, it will directly come to you only, because it is one-to-one connection, the path has been defined and everything has been defined. Whereas when you are writing a letter, when you are writing an email, that letter or email will go from different path, so that it should have source address as well as destination address, from where it has come and to where it has to go. This is what we call as connection letter, connectionless type of networking. Now what is the fourth point, which says the connectionless properties makes data packet reach the destination in any order, which means that they can potentially be received out of order at the receiver end. I have sent the packet 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, but at the receiver's end what I have got is like 1, 3, 4, 2. In this order I have got the packets. Whereas in connection oriented, if at all if I have sent in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 format, I will be receiving the packets in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 format. In connectionless, if at all if I have sent in 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 format, I might reach or I might receive the packets in 4, 5, 3, 2, 1 way, or 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 way, or 2, 3, 1, 4, 5 way. Anything can happen. It means the connectionless type of internet networking is dynamic. It is dynamic. It will not receive in an ordered way. It will not be received in order way. What is the fifth one, which says datagram networks are not as reliable as virtual circuit. Like this is obvious. Like as the what you call as the packets are not received in an order, and as well as every of the packet is not been received at the receiver end. When compared to connectionless, connection oriented is more reliable, or virtual circuits are more reliable than datagram networks. Now what is the sixth point? It says the major drawback of datagram packets switching is that a packet can only be forwarded if resources such as buffer, CPU and bandwidth are available. In the sense, if at all the resources are available on the router, then only the packets can be forwarded, or else the packets will be discarded. Whereas in connection oriented, as every of the resources is being preoccupied, every of the resources or every of the packet will be sent freely on the network. Whereas in datagram, as it is dynamic, every time that a packet is to be sent, the router is requested to give some way. If at all there is no way out, then that packet will be discarded. This is what the thing it is saying. Buffer, CPU and bandwidth should be available to send the packet from the sender to the receiver. If it has not been there, then the packet will be discarded. In the sense, the packet will be rerouted, or the packets will not be sent at that instance. Whenever the resource is available, then only the data will be received at the receiver end. Okay. Now coming to the seventh point, but it is always easy and cost efficient to implement datagram network, as there is no extra headache of reserving resources and making a dedicated each time an application has to communicate. In the sense, in connectionless type of internet networking or connectionless type of networking, the path is dynamic. As the path is dynamic, the resources also will be dynamic. And as the resources are dynamic, the problem of being a resource available is also dynamic. The process of resources being available is also dynamic. Or I can, to make you better understand this, I can tell you, if at all if you want to go for any of a dining or any of the party, you have booked an hotel. It means the hotel is already been booked for you from this time to this time. The table is already been reserved for you. In the sense, if at all if you go from that, at that particular time, the table will always be available for you. And the second condition or the second thing can be, you are directly going for the hotel and you are seeing for the table. At that instance, if at all the table is available, then only you will be allotted the table. If at all there is no table, you should wait at the waiting room. Unless and until any of the table is being freed, then only you will be allowed to go and sit on the table. The same thing happens over here. With reference to virtual circuit, the table is already been booked. whereas with reference to datagram network or connectionless internet networking, the table is to be allocated dynamically. The table is to be allocated dynamically. It means if at all the resource is available, packets will be sent. If at all the resources are not available, the packets will be discarded. Now, with this example, if you can understand, if at all there are 10 tables in a hotel and 10 people are pre-booking them, it means all of the 10 resources are being allocated. If at all the 11th person comes, he should wait until that particular time span should complete. In the sense, from 10 to 11, after 11 only the packets or the tables will be free. Whereas if at all 10 dynamic people are coming in a restaurant, 11 can also come as the first might leave. Because they are very much dynamic. Or the first may not leave, the 11th has to wait. So this is what we call as dynamic type of situation in a network or in a real life. We can understand the real life example. Okay. Now it is generally used by IP network, which is used for data services like internet. Now, the next topic that we are going to study is tunneling. What actually is a tunneling and why we are going to use a tunneling type of a network? I'll just give you an overview so that you'll get an idea what actually a tunneling is. Before going to that, have you ever heard about a tunnel? A tunnel, in a sense, tunnel will be a subway between two different paths to avoid congestions on the main path. To avoid the congestion on the main path, a sub path will be taken, which is an alternate route to transfer the information, to transfer the data, to transfer the people from one place to another place. That concept of tunnels is called as tunneling over here in computer networks. Now, coming towards, tunneling is a protocol that allows for the secure movement of data from one network to another. Now, what do you mean by this? This means in every other network, the data that is being transferred will always be secure. Then only we will be able to rely on that particular network. Then only we will be sending the packets on that network from sender to receiver or receiver to sender in any of the format. If at all that is not secure, we will not be able to send the data on the network. But why it is telling that tunneling is the secure movement of data? In the sense, on the main route that is being taken, a sub route will also be taken so that important information or some of the information that need to be sent immediately can be sent on that particular network. In the sense, tunneling is a protocol or a set of instructions that allows for the secure movement of data from one network to another network. This is what we call as a tunneling. Put a second point, which says a technique of internet networking called tunneling is used when source and destination network or networks of same type are to be connected through a network of different type. What are the different types we'll be seeing? For example, let us consider an Ethernet to be connected to another Ethernet through a wide area network. The first and the second thing is to be connected. The first and host, like host A and host B, is to be connected, and they are from same Ethernet and Ethernet 2. This has been connected with a wireless network, creating a tunnel. Now, what actually a tunnel does? It will encapsulate the data. Now, what do you mean by encapsulation? Encapsulation is a concept of binding of the data or grouping of the data or binding and grouping of data to form one individual unit. That is what we call as encapsulating or encapsulation. The best example of encapsulation, if you see a medicine called capsule, in that capsule there will be small medicines which are being grouped together to form one capsule. In that capsule there will be many of the medications or medicines in that is being grouped together to form one capsule. That is what we call as encapsulation concept. The same thing applies over here as encapsulation. Now this is what we call as a tunneling. This is the concept of tunneling. We will be seeing what tunneling is all about and how to, like, you know, how tunneling is being used in computer networks and what are the advantages and disadvantages with reference to the tunneling. For I think, like, with reference to the connection oriented and connection less type of internet working, you are clear with an idea. If at all if you have any doubt with reference to the connection less and connection less and connection oriented type of things, please let me know. You can comment down your numbers in the comment section. That's all for today. Hope to see you in the next session. All the best for the day. See you in the next session.